I'm Gail C., Director of Teaching and Learning here at ASD, and with me today I have our three elementary coordinators, Carol for math, Katrina for literacy, and Gabby for science and social studies. Last night, some of you may have attended the elementary curriculum night. We were so pleased to see so many parents there, and we thank you for coming. So for those of you who weren't there, hopefully this podcast will help you also understand some of the information that was sent out to parents last night. I also want you to know that our coordinators have posted their PowerPoints for you on Sahifa this week as well, so you can look for them below the podcast. So what we're going to do is we'll talk a little bit about, in general, about last night, and I'd like to talk a little bit about some of the common things that we heard last night. And then what we've done is when we asked those people who attended last night to fill in an evaluation, a reflection of the evening, we gathered some questions from you, and we're going to attempt to answer some of those questions, not necessarily all of the questions, but some of the questions that were recurring questions that came up from several people. So let's begin. So first thing I want to say is that as I sat and listened to each of you give your presentations, it was very clear to me that there was a common theme that kept coming through all of your presentations. And that was absolutely anchored in our ASD vision, where we talk about learning, being fun, being creative, being authentic, being innovative, being collaborative, being data-informed, technology-infused, and definitely beyond the walls. And you heard examples from each one of our curriculum coordinators highlighting where that learning was anchored from our vision. And I think that was great to be able to put it into those terms. The one that came up, and it was addressed a lot in your reflections, was fun. So we are fun at ASD. But let's start with our questions. I'll go first. And my first question is, are we collaborating with other schools? And absolutely, we are collaborating with other schools, particularly the schools in this region. We have some of our coordinators who get together with teachers from other and coordinators from other schools when we have conferences. We've hosted a couple of regional conferences here where teachers have come in from other schools and have worked together. I myself liaise a lot with the other curriculum coordinators in the region. And also we connect even on a bigger, more global sense with connections through consultants that we bring in who are working stateside and in other international schools, not just in our region. So we really do collaborate with other schools. We're not doing this work in isolation, and we certainly are looking at what's happening and best practice in other schools and in the United States. So that's my first question. Do you have a question, Carol?
Yes. Well, last night in math, we introduced the fact that we have made the final step from using Aero standards to the Common Core standards from the United States. And a parent asked, will the transition to the new standards cause difficulties for children? And the reality is, we were so aligned, the two sets of standards were so aligned before, that the children probably won't notice much difference. The content themselves is virtually the same. There could be some rigor coming, so the kids might find themselves being asked to explain things in a greater depth. So otherwise, I think we said it's a tweak, not a leap.
And I think the fact that we've been a conceptually based math program for many, many years, we're set really well to move into this new direction.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, my Katrina. Turn. Does balanced literacy leave out phonics? The key word there, if it's balanced, then there has to be an element of phonological awareness built in. And indeed, it is built in both through our word study program, as well as in our standards. It's reflected in not only the language foundation part of our standards, but also in the reading foundation part. So phonological awareness is a part of our balanced literacy program. Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Katrina. I'm Gabby, the Social Studies and Science Coordinator, so my questions are addressed
in the science domain and social studies domain, but my first question from the parents is why doesn't the science subject, is it not included as one of the MAP testing subjects? The history for this is that in the past we have used MAP data in science, but it actually didn't give us a good reflection and reporting or a collection, a snapshot of our students, because our curriculum is vertically spiralled from pre-K through to grade 5 in elementary as a banded system. As we move to next generation science standards, you'll find that there's more of an alignment to subjects that are going to be taught, and we could possibly visit or consider MAPS again when we know the topics that will be taught, instead of the topics mismatching to where we've taught in our curriculum.
Thank you. The question that I have next is about other languages in addition to English. And I know that last night's presentation, we just focused really on our core subjects of math, language, arts, science and social studies. But our other subjects also are very important to us. And I know the world languages, but people will definitely say that world language is a core subject as well. Our children have an opportunity to take Arabic and Spanish in the elementary school. One thing that you should know is our Arabic program has included kindergarten now for our MSA program. So that's something for you to watch if you have someone in kindergarten. That will be a new program starting this year. Carol.
Yes. Another parent was concerned about understanding whether their child was at the appropriate level in math, what's considered grade appropriate or grade ready. Honestly, the best way to respond to this is probably through a principal's coffee, where we get together again and take it down to what does math look like at each of the specific levels. Last night was more about the big picture, but we are looking at having other times where we get into the grade level expectations.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, following along with that, what system are we using to evaluate reading? So again, how do we know if our children have access to what's appropriate? My response to that is that we have multiple ways of assessing our children to make sure that we are tracking their growth, and such as the DRA, which is the Developmental Reading Assessment. We have MAP as well, Measure of Academic Progress. We have running records, so that is when the teacher sits down with a child and a book and takes notes. It's a special system where we're taking notes and looking and evaluating and looking at what happened and what are their strengths, what's their next step. And then we have conferring, and conferring can happen in small strategy groups. It can happen one-to-one, where again, we have conversations about reading and observing what the child can do, their skills, their strategies, and looking for that next step. So how do we evaluate reading? We evaluate it in multiple ways. Mm-hmm. Thanks, Katrina. The next question is, the science and math curriculum needs annual reviews. To answer that, in terms of what we do here at ASD, is absolutely been built into our coordinator's role, working with specified reps and teams to evaluate key assessments. The standards are not as such changing. We're looking at building the rigor into the program, and that absolutely every subject is something that comes under annual review.
Thanks, Gabby. My final question is, will MAP testing be introduced in grade 2? Last year we ran a pilot of two classes doing the MAP testing for grade 2. This year we have stretched that, and the whole of the grade will be involved in MAP testing, and that first testing is coming up very soon. The students will be tested 3 times during the year so that we get a baseline at the beginning of the year. We see how they're progressing just after winter break so that we can make any adjustments that we need in their instruction, and then we assess at the end of the year to have a look at the growth the students have made. So definitely grade 2 is being tested with MAP.
A parent here is concerned about how to make math fun. That we did talk a lot, there was a theme between all of us, that learning is fun. I think the best way to address this is that ensuring that parents address all learning with a positive attitude. It can't be seen as a drudgery or a chore. If any student is starting to be frustrated with math homework, it's time to stop. As long as it's true frustration and not an Oscar Award performance. So the idea that it's fun, we're not talking bells and whistles, we're talking about enjoying learning. So as long as parents sitting down, approaching the learning, helping each other, asking questions, it's not trying to ask gotcha, I can prove you're right or I can prove you wrong. The questions are about helping the child learn. So keep the positive attitude.
And following that, there was a question around helping children with their homework. And I'd like to refer to some of the big ideas that came back to us about what was consolidated. And one parent, I thought, summed it up beautifully. Be positive, work together, make sure you have a commitment of time to your child, ask them to explain their thinking, and remember to learn together. And on top of that, I think that Carol had also mentioned a principal coffee session. We could do individual coffee sessions where we can really dig into some hands-on activities at that time. As Carol mentioned, last night was sort of a broad overview of what happens at the school. But I look forward to learning together some more at a parent coffee session where we'll dig into how to specifically help your children in the individual disciplines.
So those are our questions for today, and I thank our coordinators, particularly for last night's presentation, also for the ongoing work that they do on a day-to-day basis with your students and with our teachers. They're leaders for both students and teachers. Please make sure that you keep connected with us. If you have any questions, all of our doors are open to you all the time. The Sahifa, these podcasts that we do, the principal's coffees, all ways to be connected and to stay informed. So thank you for those who attended last night, and have a good day.